Hey y'all. Today's a video that's a little bit different. There's not a week that goes by that somebody doesn't ask me about what screen capture software I use to make these VCarve tutorials. So I figured I'd go ahead and give you an idea as to what I do here. I use a program called Flashback Express by Blueberry Software. I went ahead and I looked for it in Google. This is the link to it, flashbackrecorder.com/express. I'll put a link in the description. And there is a pro version. I have not yet found a need for it. Everything I do is on the free version. It does what I need it to do. I don't do any editing or text or video effects within the screen capture software. And all of this editing has to do only with its native format. So I use the free Express version. You do have to register it to an email address. And as far as spam or anything else is concerned, I've never even received an email from these people. So it's not like they're going to spam your inbox. It's a good product. I like it. I'll go ahead and close this now. And I'll go ahead and bring it up and show you how it works and how I use it. I have a shortcut here on my start menu. The first time you start it that day, you'll get a splash screen up here that says upgrade to pro. Just click no thanks and you'll get into this screen right here. In this screen, you have several choices. I always record full screen. Make sure you click on record sound. Don't ask me how I know this is important. It's very important. Your microphone selection is also important. Don't ask me how I know that too. Some people have asked me about how I get my screen capture software to play the sounds that Windows makes. I also record the default PC speakers. Okay, so I have a check mark in all three of these right here. Now, if we come up here to Tools, Options, I'll show you a few more options that we have here. What I have this set at is it's recording my PC speakers and the microphone on a separate track. This is where you set your sound format. I don't record with MP3 compression. I do that change in post-production. You can set it up to record your webcam while you're doing screen capture. I don't do that, and you have a choice of where you want to place the webcam capture, be it, you know, up in this corner, down in this corner, what have you. You have various different parameters here that you can set. I set it to auto hide my desktop icons and auto hide my taskbar. That's why occasionally you'll see me get a cursor down here and my taskbar pop up. I'm in the weird position right now of using a different screen capture program to capture this screen capture program. And it doesn't hide my taskbar, so that's why you're seeing everything down here. It will record your keystrokes, but it does not place those keystrokes on the screen. You can set up system hotkeys to start and stop recording. Updates, file size limiting, etc. I don't do any of that. And advanced, I don't do much of that either. Now in Flashback, you'll notice there's a yellow disk around my cursor pointer. That is set within the software. That's the default. I didn't do that at all. So there's my options. I'll go ahead and I'll record a real quick little something to show you a few things. Basically, I start it up. I make sure I'm in full screen. I make sure I have the correct microphone set that I have check marks here and that I have default PC speakers. Then I'll click on record, and it kind of does its little tap dance here. You'll notice my taskbar went away. It gives me a countdown. Then it gives me that Windows bling sound. I'm now recording, and I don't know if this is going to show up with the yellow cursor or not. We'll find out. Okay, I don't know if you saw or not, but on my countdown 1, 2, 3 screen, the command to stop recording is Control Shift S, which I just tapped on my keyboard. What do I want to do with this recording? I can discard it, I can save it, or I can review it. I'm going to go ahead and save it to show you how I export it. I'll put this up on my desktop and I'll call it Capture. That's good enough. Save. Okay. I don't know why I still have that open. Okay, now, after saving that, there's the file. It saves it in its proprietary format, which is an FBR file. And there isn't a lot you can do with it except play it in the Flashback Express. When you download Flashback Express, you get the recorder here. You also get the player. So all I'm going to do with this proprietary file that I just recorded is double-click it to open up the player. And when the player opens up, down, then it automatically starts playing. I guess I shouldn't do it that way, but what the heck. I'll go back to the first frame. I don't play videos in this player. I use it only to export video. And for that, I've got my video loaded in the player. I'll come up here to File, Export. I select MP4. OK. I have this window that pops up asking me some general questions, the whole movie, my scaling, frame rate, video and sound quality, which codec I want to use. Once I have all that set up, then I'll click export, and much the same thing. Put it on my desktop, name it, save. It'll do its dance. Do I want to view it? No, not through the player. I'll close the player. Then I've got my MP4 file here, which I can edit in Corel Video Studio. I'll go ahead down. Then it gives me that Windows bling sound. I'm now recording, and I don't know if this is going to show up with the yellow cursor. Okay. This is Captureception, I guess you would call it, because I was just playing a video that I captured while I'm videoing on other capture software. Anyhow, that's how it turns out. That's how I see it. I can then go ahead and edit it in my standard editing software and then post it on YouTube. I know this is a quick, brief little overview, but I've had so many questions about the screen capture software. It really is as easy as I just showed you. There's not a whole lot of changes I made to any of those settings. Again, over here in Tools, Options, I didn't make very many changes at all. Just make sure I have PC speakers, record microphone in a separate track. I set my sample rate to 96 kilohertz. And that's about, now I take that back, desktop. Hide desktop icons and auto hide taskbar. Those are the only changes I made to any of the default settings. As you can see, it does what I want it to do. I hope that helped you out. If you'd like to keep abreast of what I'm doing here, be it in Flashback Express or VCarve Pro or Mach 3, I do hope you'll subscribe to my channel. Whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch. Y'all take care.